Good evening, and welcome to live music. Such a concept. In 1971, when I was 22 years of age, I was teaching at Villa Maria Institute of Music when Sister Martinell, the director, assigned me this 10-year-old student, our very own Michael Serio, to instruct on the piano. And I very quickly realized I was dealing with one of the most talented young musicians in the area. So I thought it was my duty pretty quickly to find a piano teacher of Professor Huebner's stature or Professor Manist's stature, or back in my time, it was Professor August Martin, who had taught here at UB when I was a student and was now teaching at Villa Maria College and Villa Maria Institute. So Michael dusted me off and asked if I would join on his program this evening. I have not played for a live audience since February 9th, 2020. So I'm very excited. I'm a little bit nervous, but I am honored. I am honored to be the program opener for tonight's real featured artist, Michael Serio, Nicolaus Bruhns.
Thank you. Thank you all for coming. 4 years ago, my friend Jim Kosnik, one of my first piano teachers, suggested we perform a concert together. I was honored to do a program with Jim and readily agreed. Of course, neither one of us had any idea of what the next 4 years would be like. Somehow we've managed to find rehearsal times when Jim's been in town to cobble together today's program. It's been a great joy to collaborate with Jim. He's an outstanding musician, one of the sweetest, kindest people I know. I'm grateful beyond words for Jim's dedication and willingness to perform this program together. Thank you, Jim. I also wish to thank concert manager Phil Rehard and his team for their help in making this program possible. This concert has been postponed twice due to the pandemic. I'm so delighted that we're finally able to offer this program to you tonight. And a special thanks to my partner Anandi, who's patiently endured many hours of piano practice and rehearsals. She may actually be able to play some of these pieces. I'm so grateful for her love, support, and encouragement. The word homage is defined as a public show of respect or honor towards someone or something. Homage is a reference to Ravel's Le Tombeau de Couperin, his tribute to the French Baroque keyboard masters, and in particular, François Couperin. In today's program, I wish to pay homage not only to Ravel and his masterpiece, but to all of the great classical musical masters of the piano repertoire who've created a priceless treasure of music that has brought countless hours of joy to me and all who experience it. It's an honor and privilege for me to share some of that music with you tonight. I also wish to pay homage to the people who've supported and inspired me in my lifelong love affair with piano. First Jim, and then August Martin, a dear dedicated teacher that we both share, introduced me to the world of classical piano and the music of the great masters. Jim and I pay homage to the memory of August Martin tonight and the many years of support that he provided to both of us. Nearly 20 years ago, in the fall of 2002, my first Alexander Technique teacher, Debbie Adams, helped me begin the process of rediscovering the joy of piano performance. Tommy Thompson and other wonderful Alexander Technique teachers have contributed greatly to this ongoing rediscovery process. In 2017, when I was unsure about returning to UB to pursue a Master of Music performance after a brief 35-year hiatus, Jim was unequivocal in his support and guidance. At UB, my phenomenal piano teacher, Eric Huebner, the brilliant faculty, staff, and students have made this return to music a dream come true. I'm especially grateful for the love and support from my parents who are watching on YouTube, thanks to this wonderful technology that we have. I know they would be here if they could. I'm grateful for the love and support from my son Tony, my family members, friends, and the friendly audiences who've encouraged and guided me to help keep this desire alive for all these years. There's no substitute for a live audience, and it's so wonderful to be performing for live audiences again. Finally, I would be remiss if I didn't pay homage to those we've lost to the pandemic and to all the scientists, world leaders, and frontline healthcare providers who continue tirelessly to do all that they can to keep us alive and safe. I'd like to close with a few words about Ravel's Le Tombeau de Couperin. I found it quite interesting to learn that this was Ravel's last solo piano work, although he continued to write mostly chamber and orchestral music for another 20 years. This suite was written during World War I between 1914 and 1917. Each movement is dedicated to a friend who died in the war. Ravel, who was an ambulance driver during the war, witnessed many horrific, unspeakable acts. Despite this, he created a lighthearted, reflective, and uplifting work. When criticized that this work wasn't somber enough, Ravel replied, "The dead are sad enough in their eternal silence." please silence your cell phones, and let's enjoy these gifts of great music and live performances together. Thank you very much.
isn't Michael Serio just remarkable in that Ravel toccata? So inspirational, and more is to come. So for Katie, in your program, for 30 years, I was an organist at a parish in Norfolk, Virginia, and I got to know her family very, very well, and I got to know Katie when she was a munchkin, and she was in the Christmas pageant as a little angel, and then a little older shepherdess, and then by high school, a big angel, and I had absolutely no clue whatsoever that she suffered from horrific melancholia. Just devastating. And so she lost the fight, and she died a relatively young woman, and I was just beside myself in terms of not catching on, not saying anything, not being helpful. So I stayed in touch with her family, and her family had picked a text that they wanted me to be inspired by, and it was from the tune St. Thomas. And it's in the second stanza, I believe, of the tune that the text refers to deeply wailing, deeply wailing. And so that's what inspired me to write what's a pretty optimistic piece. I like to think it's a pretty optimistic piece because of the melody. So all of you know, I mean, just in this COVID nightmare that we have come through, people who have not come through with us. And so as I play this composition, I hope you will lift up those individuals as I dedicate this to the memory of Katie.
The next work is The Lament of the Maiden and Nightingale by Enrique Granados, a Spanish composer who lived during the same time period as Maurice Ravel. Granados' music was heavily influenced by Chopin and Liszt. This is a movement of a suite entitled Goyescas, in homage to the paintings of Francisco Goya. Granados wrote an opera based on this movement, and because World War I prevented him from premiering it in Paris, he went to New York City and premiered it at the Metropolitan Opera in 1916. The opera was a huge success, and Granados was offered many opportunities to perform piano recitals, including an invitation to perform for President Woodrow Wilson. These concerts caused him to delay his return trip to Spain. Tragically, he booked a return trip on a ship to England, which was torpedoed by a German submarine. The story goes that he and his wife were in a lifeboat, and she fell overboard, and he jumped in to rescue her, and they both drowned. Granados and his wife left 6 children. So I now offer you The Lament of the Maiden and Nightingale from Goyescas by Enrique Granados.
Thank you.